spectroscopy.
So as far as application areas are concerned, so I have included three key areas that I worked on in the last 1 to 2 years, and I always say these, I mean, the microplastics, the EVIS, and the opioids. So I want to tell you stories basically based on things that we learned from each of these different applications when we did, and how small changes in the instrumentation, how small changes in the software actually helped us do this better, as well as how, because there was a need, just like Andrew mentioned, there was a need or there was a requirement in the field that that a solution is required, that we forced ourselves and we forced some of our partner companies to help us out to do things way better. So that's why I said I'll divide this into two different areas. And just like you heard in Raman advances, so one of the ways IR is also going is because IR as well as Raman are two very mature technologies. So where the next step of these are going is to combine it with all the different instrumentation. So in today's talk, I will focus on 3 to 4 key areas, which actually is very beneficial for folks who are looking at polymers. So that is to combine techniques with TGA, combined techniques with rheometer, combined techniques of FTIR and FT-Raman in one instrumentation, and I will tell you a little story of that as far as when we talk about opioids, as well as development of some new really nice fiber optic probes. So with near-infrared, with Raman, the optical probes, or doing remote analysis, or anything like that was pretty well established so far, but where IR didn't have an advantage is the availability of really good probes as well as really good ATR probes, because folks really want to get good quality data, right? So these are the areas we will touch upon today, depending on how much time we have. And I have some examples of what we have done and we have tried to do with a lot of different polymers in all these different types of combinations. So, the first and foremost part I definitely want to talk about is microplastics, definitely. So I always say, I mean, my last 4 years with studying these microplastics from different groups, as well as from a lot of different samples, has been very interesting. We have looked at samples from a lot of different environments, a lot of different types of collection modes, and almost what you will see in the next couple of slides is it's almost everywhere. It's like there is no one place that I haven't found some plastic that would make me feel good. But it's just not there. So it's like it's everywhere. So and yes, the way most of the questions that came into us is like how much load, what type of identity, what kind of information can we provide. And this is where the instruments advances as well as the software advances in the instrumentation help. And tomorrow you will see, so it's very interesting that, so the software that we will use tomorrow, that had a